Goedenavond, dames en heren. Vanuit onze huiskamer naar jullie huiskamer. I say from our living room because I think for musicians, music is the room where we live. And for me, my partner, which most days is always with me, is this viola that was made 431 years ago in northern Italy. Its wood came from spruce trees cut at the light of the full moon, every millimeter of the inside of its body carved with such precision and with such care that for centuries after, it can still sound so beautiful. And then the world got a lot louder. So if you imagine that from 1589 until the invention of the modern piano, this beast with all of these keys and so much potential for sound, how much changed in the world? And now, of course, if we put a piano on the stage of an enormous amphitheater, we wouldn't even hear it. And so the question, I guess, for musicians is, what connects all of this? How do I, as someone who plays a quiet instrument, imagine myself when I play with an instrument that is as powerful as a piano? And it's true, the viola will never be this virtuoso force. We're not the leading lady in the film. It's my job to persuade, my job to seduce with sound, to imagine who I'm playing, what's my character, what's the conversation that I'm having. I think of myself as musical glue, and when I play with a group of people like we're about to do, my job is not just to play the melody, but to understand exactly how the conversation between all of the characters fits together. Even though I can't see the pianist who's playing behind me, even if I only met that person yesterday or 2 days ago, it's my job to feel the power of their energy and sense what it is that they want to say while playing my own part, while listening to the other parts. This is something I think quite unique in a way to the job of the viola. And it's interesting, of course, why is a violist talking to you at a piano festival? But in this sense of how the world connects, and I know for myself, it's the first day I'm back on the stage in such a long time, and I think we can all say how powerful it is, this connection to play together, how powerful probably it is for everyone to spend time with each other now. And so more than ever, I feel that as a musician playing something that was made in the 16th century and sometimes playing music that was written last week and sometimes playing music that was written 200 years ago, for me, what this is to float on this raft of human history and to feel what we have in common, actually. And sometimes it seems now that it's easier to think about what we don't have in common, but how precious it is, actually, to feel that this sense of music binds us together. So at the airport, when people say, well, what do you do for a living? Probably the most honest answer is I'm a professional listener, because in the end, right, it's not the instrument, large or small, that is what moves us, right? The instrument is just a tool. It's our ears. It's the connection between people that actually produces sound that makes a difference. And so I would say to our friends in government and our friends in technology, thinking about what's tomorrow about, if you do not have a population of listeners who can, with open minds and hearts, listen to each other and to what you're saying, every idea you have will fail. And this is why culture is still important, even in a time of crisis. I would say more than ever in a time of crisis, that we need to remember how to listen in a deep way, which is very different from consuming, scrolling, looking, impressing. to listen is actually to show to someone else that we believe they have dignity and that we ourselves believe that we have dignity. And then there is the vulnerability to meet in the middle, which is exactly what happens when musicians in person make music together. So I would say music is the room we live in, music is the room we love in, and it's the room that we listen in. And I would say thank you so much for listening to us.